Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be talking about when you can experience your first lucid dream. If you're new here, my name is Giz Edwards and I'm a lucid dreaming coach and entrepreneur based here in the UK. Yes, my voice did just crack a little bit then. And on this channel, we delve into lucid dreaming, entrepreneurship and more to make your lives more enjoyable, fulfilling and relaxed. And with that out of the way, let's talk about when you can expect your first lucid dream. Many times you'll find people panicking because they have tried and practiced to learn to lucid dream and they still haven't had their first lucid dream. Well, this is the seventh video in my lucid dreaming playlist. And in this small section of the video series, I'll be delving into expectation setting, this video being one of them. This video is aimed to put you in the right frame of mind when learning how to lucid dream. Expectation setting is important, guys. So when can you expect your first lucid dream? Well, there are a couple of answers for this. There was a study a while back, and for the life of me, I cannot find the study no matter how much I try and look for it on the internet. It just seems to have disappeared into the ether. I don't know how. But within this study, it said that the research found that people can expect their first lucid dream anywhere between 3 and 21 days after finding out about lucid dreaming. Now, there are a couple of caveats to that, and this is where the there's a couple of answers for this question statement comes from. I think the first thing to note is that we don't know this study because I can't find it. I can't research how good the study is. I don't know the participants. I don't know if they slept well. I don't know if they were meditation students. I don't know X, Y, Z, A, B, C. You get my point. There's a lot of stuff in this study that I don't know because I cannot find the study. If anybody has found the study, I will pin their comment with a link. So 3 to 21 days doesn't sound too bad, does it? Well, as I said, a couple of caveats. Because I don't know the study, I'm going to have to make a couple of assumptions on it. First of all, we don't know the three main factors in achieving stuff, which are effort, unfair advantage, and luck. So we're just going to talk a little bit briefly about those three aspects so that you have a better understanding of why they are important. Let's talk about effort. I've been lucid dreaming and lucid dreaming coaching for a long time now, and the amount of times I've received an email that goes somewhere around this kind of line. Hey, can you help me? I'm trying to lucid dream and I haven't had one yet. And I respond with the lines of something similar to, well, how long have you been practicing? Oh, about 4 days now. Okay, do you keep a dream journal? No. And you'll be surprised how many times I've had that kind of interaction with people. Firstly, the amount of effort you put in. A dream journal is one of the most important tools to a lucid dreamer. If you're not keeping a dream journal for at least a few weeks, then don't bother asking for help because you haven't put enough effort on your part. Even if I were to help you, I'd give you that advice. Keep a dream journal. I'll be making a video about dream journals and which one was most effective for me in the near future. So if you want to stick around for that, please subscribe. Dream journals will help you remember more of your dreams. When you remember more of your dreams, it increases your chance of becoming lucid. The dream recall is very important. The second part of effort are things that you do to help. For example, reality checks. How much time do you put into reality checks? How much effort do you put into reality checks? Because reality checks mixed with dream journals equals very much increased chances of lucidity. If you're not putting in effort into those two categories, then you're expected to be above the 21-day mark, way above. So let's talk about unfair advantage now. So this study doesn't tell me whether or not the participants in the study have good sleep habits. Having a good sleep habit, a morning routine, an evening routine, is very vital for lucid dreaming because, again, if you have a positive sleep habit, it increases your chances of becoming lucid because your sleep health is a lot better. Your REM periods will be bigger. You have more REM periods during the night because of each sleep cycle if your sleep habits are healthy. Therefore, some people just happen to have better dream recall naturally because they have better sleep habits or they have a better connection between them and the dream. I fell into this category quite heavily because when I went to lucid dream for my first time, I became lucid on the first night. But I don't think I would have been able to do that unless I had good sleep habits, which I did at the time. And I also had a very positive connection between myself and the dream. I just naturally could remember a lot more of my dreams than, say, my friend or my brother or, you know, whoever. So that counts as something called unfair advantage. The last thing is luck. For lucid dreaming, people are lucky in two ways. First of all, something in a dream can trigger lucidity separate to your conscious self. So it's not you reacting to something, it's someone saying, oh, you're lucid, or you see the words lucidity, or somebody is talking about lucid dreaming. But even if you have that luck, you still have to be conscious enough to apply what you know to what you could potentially be doing, which is lucid dreaming. So you still have to be quite aware of lucid dreaming in order to turn that kind of lucky state into an active dream, lucid dream. And on top of that, some researchers have indicated that there may be a genetic factor that attributes to your natural proficiency for lucid dreaming. Some people, perhaps, are just more, they just have better aptitude for lucidity than other people just naturally. Obviously, some people don't believe this, and the research, you know, we still need to do a lot more on that, but it's just a theory, albeit not shared by everyone. So think of lucid dreaming as a cake, and the recipe for that is effort, unfair advantage, and luck. You mix those together, and the time it takes you to get this lucid dream is anywhere between 3 and 21 days. Just remember, everybody's built differently, everyone puts in different amounts of effort, have different levels of luck, have different unfair advantages, or a combination of. I like to think of lucid dreaming as bodybuilding. It would be unwise to think that within 3 to 21 days you're going to have six-pack abs and massive muscles. Just doesn't happen. It takes time, and a lot of small steps count up towards doing something big. Just because you're not seeing the results straight away doesn't mean that they are not there. The same goes for lucid dreaming. Keep at it. When I restarted my lucid dreaming journey recently, I started writing in my dream journal, and over 7 days I had 23 dream journal entries. And in that first week I had a lucid dream. Without identifying dream signs, without doing reality checks, all I did was increase the amount of dream recall I had, and I became lucid within a dream. It shows that even though I wasn't doing the techniques for lucidity, the very fact that my dreams were so clear and vivid helped towards my chances. 1 week it took me. You've got this. So that's it for this video. If you want to stick around to learn about lucid dreaming, then click that subscribe button. I don't know why I turned into Mr. T. Yeah, that's it. And I'll see you all on Wednesday. Until then, bye.